We greet you this morning. This is the 17th Sunday after Trinity. Let's rise and sing our opening hymn, hymn 474. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord. Righteous art thou, O Lord, and true is thy judgment. Blessed are those that are undefiled in the way,
and walk in the
be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Righteous art thou, O Lord, true is thy judgment.
Jesus Christ saith, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, we pray thee that thy grace may always prevent and follow us, and make us continually to be given to all good works, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with thee and the Holy Ghost ever, one God, world without end.
Amen. Here beginneth the 15th verse of the 13th chapter of the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Hear ye and give ear, be not proud, for the Lord hath spoken. Give glory to the Lord your God before he cause darkness, and before your feet stumble upon the dark mountains. And while ye look for light, he turn it into the shadow of death and make it gross darkness. But if ye will not hear it, my soul shall weep in secret places for your pride. And mine eyes shall weep sore and run down with tears, because the Lord's flock is carried away captive. Say unto the king and to the queen, Humble yourselves, sit down, for your principalities shall come down, even the crown of your glory. The cities of the south shall be shut up, and none shall open them. Judah shall be carried away captive, all of it. It shall be wholly carried away captive. Lift up your eyes and behold them that come from the north. Where is the flock that was given thee, thy beautiful flock? What wilt thou say when he shall punish thee? For thou hast taught them to be captains and as chief over thee. Shall not sorrows take thee as a woman in travail? Here endeth the lesson.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 25. Found on page 369 of the Book of Common Prayer. Psalm 25 on page 369 of the prayer book. Unto thee, O Lord, will I lift up my soul. My God, I have put my trust in thee. O let me not be confounded, neither let mine enemies triumph over me.
For all they that hope in thee shall not be ashamed. But such as transgress without a cause shall be put to confusion.
Show me thy ways, O Lord, and teach me thy paths.
Lead me forth in thy truth and learn me, for thou art the God of my salvation. In thee hath been my hope all the day long.
Call to remembrance, O Lord, thy tender mercies and thy loving kindnesses which have been ever of old.
O remember not the sins and offenses of my youth, but according to thy mercy, think thou upon me, O Lord, for thy goodness.
Gracious and righteous is the Lord, therefore will he teach sinners in the way.
Them that are meek shall he guide in judgment, and such as are gentle, them shall he learn his way.
All the paths of the Lord are mercy and truth unto such as keep his covenant and his testimonies.
For thy name's sake, O Lord, be merciful unto my sin, for it is great.
What man is he that feareth the Lord? Him shall he teach in the way that he shall choose.
His soul shall dwell at ease, and his seed shall inherit the land.
The secret of the Lord is among them that fear him, and he will show them his covenant.
Mine eyes are ever looking unto the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net.
Turn thee unto me, and have mercy upon me. for I am desolate and in misery.
The sorrows of my heart are enlarged. O bring thou me out of my troubles.
Look upon my adversity and misery, and forgive me all my sin.
Consider mine enemies, how many they are, and they bear a tyrannous hate against me.
O keep my soul and deliver me. Let me not be confounded, for I have put my trust in thee.
Let perfectness and righteous dealing wait upon me, for my hope hath been in thee.
Deliver Israel, O God, out of all his troubles.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The epistle is written in the fourth chapter of the epistle of St. Paul to the Ephesians, beginning at the first verse. I, therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith ye are called, with all lowliness and meekness, with longsuffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. Y'all need to be a bit more alive today. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
It came to pass as Jesus went into the house of one of the chief Pharisees to eat bread on the Sabbath day, that they watched him. And behold, there was a certain man before him which had the dropsy. And Jesus answering spake unto the lawyers and Pharisees, saying, Is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath day? And they held their peace. And he took him, and healed him, and let him go. And answered them, saying, Which of you shall have an ass or an ox fallen into a pit, and will not straightway pull him out on the Sabbath day? And they could not answer him again to these things. And he put forth a parable to those which were bidden, when he marked out how they chose out the chief seats, saying unto them, When thou art bidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest seat, lest a more honorable man than thou be bidden of him. And he that bade thee and him come to say to thee, Give this man place, and thou begin with shame to take the lowest place. But when thou art bidden, go and sit down in the lowest place, that when he that bade thee cometh, he may say unto thee, Friend, go up higher. Then shalt thou have worship in the presence of them that sit at meat with thee. For whosoever exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Thank you.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please be seated. Good morning. Good to see everybody today. There we go. Now, see, that's a more enthusiastic response, what I'm talking about. Anyway, for those of you who are visiting, we bid you welcome, and we're so glad you could join us worshiping our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ today. Well, this keeps happening. 8 o'clockers are filling this church up. That's amazing. It actually is. It's really kind of different. But anyway, I guess everybody likes to get up early in the day. So, but it's good to have all of y'all here. This is awesome. Now, this week, Fish Fry is Friday. You can pick up your tickets. Kathy, I guess Cynthia has the pack back there somewhere. You do too? Okay. So anyway, pick up. Also, today is our the first day that we're bringing back the actual meals afterwards. And I know we got chicken spaghetti and Kathy's famous cheesy bread and all that sort of good stuff. So please stick around. And beautiful salad and, you know, all the desserts. Oh, okay. 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 So sign up.
Right in front of where the plates are.
As Larry the Cable Guy says, get her done, okay? All right. So we've got that going on. Remember the cookbook, get your recipes in, and the basket raffle. We thought we were going to start today. We couldn't, didn't get the baskets done, but they will be here on Friday at the Fish Fry. So you know, be sure to do that. And you know, it's that time of year. We got everything going on, and I'm going to put this out there right now. The bishop might be coming at the end of October. We don't know. It's just it kind of popped up, and he's got a hole in his schedule, and I wasn't going to bother him this year since he just took over the diocese back at the beginning of August. And so, but he called me up, and he says, I'd really like to come. Can we? And I said, well, yeah, we'll work out the logistics, and we'll let you know, okay? So if he comes, it'll probably be on Halloween. I don't know if that's appropriate or what, but anyway, but Bishop Chad would appreciate that I made reference to that. So anyway, all right. How about the blessing of birthdays and anniversaries? Anyone had one in the past week? Nope. All right, Todd, how about our sermon hymn today, hymn 287? Thank you. today's gospel lesson, Jesus said, "For whosoever exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted." In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Please be seated. Our gospel lesson today, at the very least, is actually a very good piece of practical wisdom. Jesus says, you know, go take the lowest seat, because if you don't do that and you go to the high seat, you might get embarrassed in public. And Jesus doesn't want you to be embarrassed. And yet, he says at the end of the parable, and this puts it on a whole nother different level than just a piece of practical advice. He said, "For whosoever exalteth himself shall be abased, and he that humbleth himself shall be exalted." And so, with those words, Jesus lifts this practical advice really up to the level of a parable. You see, Jesus had been taking note of what was going on around him when he arrived at the Pharisee's house. And in a gentle irony, he lays out about the elbowings, the schemings, the social ambition that he saw going on before him. And he uses this all-too-human scene to teach, by contrast, the standards of the messianic banquet. Now, we all know a wedding is a formal occasion, or at least it was until the millennials got a hold of it. And the mother and father of the bride, the hosts of the wedding feast, the reception, whatever you want to call it, they would take care to honor guests according to their rank and status in the lives of them, in the lives of the couple. And also, and it certainly was quite frequent in years past, certainly, that people were honored by their rank in society also. Now, there's a story that's told. Just think about a wedding, and you see this, and you can see social ambition actually rearing its head. There's a story told of a rabbi by the name of Simeon ben Shittah. And Simeon was invited to join King Janaeus at a feast. And the rabbi walked in, looked around, and immediately plopped himself down in between the king and the queen. And in a most cocky manner said, "Exalt wisdom, and she shall exalt thee, and make thee to sit among princes." He was very proud of himself because he viewed himself as the ultimate example of wisdom. There's also a story that goes around about the gods, the Greek gods, and there was a fellow by the name of Heracles. And most of you, if you're familiar with your mythology, you know that in the Roman translation, that's Hercules, the one that we all know from our Saturday morning black and white movies and cartoons and stuff and everything. Well, and Hercules, of course, warrior, right? You know, he's a demigod. His dad was a god and his mother was a human. And he'd go around, you know, wiping out all the enemies and doing all that sort of good Hercules kind of stuff. So he was a hero. And then there was a fellow by the name of Asclepius. Asclepius was also a demigod. Daddy a god, and his mama a human. And Asclepius became known for his healing powers. Not very fancy, very simple. He would heal people. And one day, Hercules came walking into the gods' banquet hall. I guess they're on Mount Olympus or wherever they were having a banquet that particular day. And saw Asclepius sitting up there at the head table near Zeus. Hercules was furious. How could a lowly, as he said, how could a lowly druggist be allowed to sit up there where I should be sitting? So you see, even so-called gods were not free from petty conceit. I mean, consider, how many people are there in the world who just bridle as soon as their dignity is abused, or so they think? Now, I know from this pulpit I have told this story before. Back many, many years ago, when I was a young priest, only about 6 months in, because it was May after I was ordained, we had a big wedding at the church where I was stationed, down in Orlando. And Bishop Grundorf, of course, was there, and I was there. Bishop Grundorf preached, and I celebrated Holy Communion and did the vows with the young couple. And so after that, it was great. Church was packed, 300 people there, and then off to the reception we went. And we went to one of the most awesome places on the planet, the City Club in Orlando, Florida. Now, if you know anything about it, that's where all the hoi polloi go, because it costs like $200,000 to become a member. So going there is like, woohoo, yeah, baby, it's awesome. And so we walk in, and I'm following the bishop along, because I'm the little rookie priest and everything, and we go get our place cards, and we have our cocktails before they open up the banquet hall, and in we go to the banquet hall, and I follow Bishop Grundorf along like I'm supposed to, you know, one step behind him, you know, that kind of thing, proper respect. And we go walking over. Bishop Grundorf goes straight to the family table, goes around his seat, pulls his seat back, sits down. There he is, right there. And I go, okay, well, I've got to be right next to him. And I went right next to him. Nope, somebody else. Walked all around that table. Rookie priest's name was not there. And Bishop Grundorf says, that's your table number down in the lower right-hand corner. It was number 19, not number 2. I was, well, okay. I couldn't even find the darn table. I actually had to ask the server where the table was. And the young woman, she looked at me, she says, well, actually, it's through that door and back behind the wall divider. And so I went back on in there. The table was completely empty. I sat down in the corner, turned around, looked towards the head table. Can't even see it. And slowly but surely, everybody trickled in and sat down. And everybody that sat at my table was 13, 14, 15, and 16 years old. So I was sitting at the kids' table, like Thanksgiving, you know? Needless to say, I was a bit annoyed and kind of like, oh my gosh. Well, honestly, it put me in my place. I got over it, and I really had a lot of fun watching those kids go to the open bar to snitch themselves something. There are out there in the world lots of books that list all sorts of virtues. I know Mr. Bennett had a pretty famous one that he did back in the 80s. But I would suggest to you that there's really only one virtue. And that virtue is the lowly acknowledgement of Almighty God. And there are also books that lists out all sorts of major sins. And as a priest, I have several of them, little manuals. But there's really only one real sin: self-worship. Our attempt to put ourselves at the center of the world, at the center of the universe. Lowliness Lowliness springs from gratitude. When God has given so much, why? Why should a person count himself worthy of any higher place at the table? Lowliness also springs from reverence. How can a sinful person presume to approach the majesty of Almighty God? And lowliness also springs from knowledge of sins forgiven. What more could one ask? That, my friends, is the lowliness that God honors. And no one is more surprised than the lowly when they are summoned to God's nearer favor. We sang it in hymn 218 today, but Dante also heard it singing in paradise when he was in purgatory. Blessed are the poor in spirit. The singers, being humble, could not understand how they had deserved heaven. God is the host. And that's what makes this parable today. He has his own standard of judgment. And Jesus is the test. Yeah, perhaps that woman out there that really has no gift in the world's eyes except a full life of prayer. Or there is that drunken man who's contrite in his sins. Why should they be at the head of the table? Because at the messianic banquet in the kingdom, God does not despise the broken and contrite heart. Because at the messianic banquet in the kingdom, God will exalt those who humble themselves. Amen. Now to God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost, do we ascribe as the most justly due great honor, glory, and majesty, both now and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Let us pray. Dearly beloved, we offer the Eucharist to stay in union with Jesus Christ, our great high priest, who continues to make intercession on our behalf in the heavens. With your prayers this day for all those who are sick and suffering, remembering especially those of this place, for Alice, Barbara, Becky, Francis, Fred, Norm, Pat, Randy, and Sally. We also pray for our family, friends, and others who need and desire our prayers, especially those we remember now in our own hearts. We pray for those who are traveling, remembering Alex and Cheryl. And we also pray for the souls of the faithful departed who share with us in this Eucharist, remembering this week Gregory, priest. In our provincial prayer cycle, we pray for Sunstar Mission in Kyle, South Dakota, and these churches in Tennessee, All Saints Church, Chattanooga, Holy Cross Church, Farragut, St. Peter the Apostle, Kingsport, Holy Comforter Church in Mount Juliet, and we also pray for St. Philip's Church in Austin, Texas. Pray, brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours also may be acceptable in the sight of God the Father Almighty. May the Lord receive this sacrifice at my hands to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, especially Joseph, our president, Roy, our governor, and all those in authority with them, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, especially Chandler, our ordinary, and all priests and deacons, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things and judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, of thy tender mercy, didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. From the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all of the benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we're unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Drink this in remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful. And now, having received the most precious body and blood of our Savior Jesus Christ, let us pray together in great thanksgiving. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Glory be to God on high. Let us pray. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.